हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस क्लास FYBCA सेमिस्टर 1. माई सेल्फ SP बोरसे एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सब्जेक्ट प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड सी प्रोग्रामिंग. इट्स कोड इज BCA 112. दिस वीडियो इज जस्ट फॉर द सिलेबस डिस्कशन. इन दिस सेमिस्टर यू विल गोइंग टू लर्न बेसिक सी प्रोग्रामिंग. So here total number of this course is 4. Examination scheme will be continuous evaluation. Now continuous evaluation means internal exams, so which is for 30 marks, and end semester, that means university exam, will be of 70 marks. So total marks for this theory paper is of 100 marks. Then its companion course is BCA 116, that is C Programming Laboratory. Total credits are 1.5. Again, in this course, continuous evaluation will be of 15 marks and end semester exam will be of 35 marks. So, for this course, practical exam will be of total 50 marks. So objectives of this subject is to provide a broad overview of problem solving techniques, to learn C programming to solve different problems. What are the course outcomes? At the end of the course, student will be able to define algorithms and explain their characteristics, formulate algorithm and draw flowchart to solve a given problem, explain use of appropriate data types, control statements. Again, it will demonstrate ability to use top-down program design. So let us start with the unit 1. It will be problem solving, algorithms and flowcharts. So in this unit, you will going to learn different types of problems. Now we have to solve these problems by using computer. Then again you will occur difficulties with the problem solving. So there are different problem solving aspects. Then you will going to see definition and characteristics of algorithms. Example of algorithms. Then from the algorithm you have to draw different flowcharts. So there are very different examples for the flowchart also. Then top-down design problem solving using arithmetic statements. Then conditional statements and iterative statements, such as different examples are there. First one is the addition or multiplication. Then to check number is positive or negative. After that, maximum of two numbers and three numbers. Then sum of first n numbers, sum of given n numbers. Then reverse digits of a number, check whether the number is palindrome or not. Next, check number is prime or not. After that, find out factorial of a number, then factors of a number. After that, find out GCD or LCM of numbers. Next unit is C fundamentals. In this unit, we will going to see introduction of C language, then different features of C language. After that, structure of C program, then C character set, then identifiers and different keywords which are always used in C programming. After that, variables and constants. Then we will going to see data types. In this, you will going to see basic data types, enumerated types, then type casting. After that, declarations, expression, how to declare different expression in C language. Then different operators and expressions. After that, different types of operators you will going to see, just like unary and binary arithmetic operators, increment decrement operators, relational and logical operators, bitwise operators, then assignment operators, comma operator, size of operator, ternary conditional operator, precedence and associativity. Unit 3 is input-output statements. In this, you will going to see different functions. The functions like printfscanf, getchar, putchar, getch, gets, puts, then escape sequence characters, after that format specifiers. Unit 4 is all about the control and iterative structures. In this, you will going to see different controlling statements. So which are the controlling statements? If else, then nested if statements, after that conditional branching, switch statements, loops. So loops are while, do while and for. After that break, continue and go to statements. Unit 5 is functions. We will see introduction to functions, which are the function arguments, then types of functions like library functions and user defined functions. Next topic is methods for parameter passing. Now parameter we have to pass to the functions. So which are the methods for passing parameter to a function? Then we will see recursion. Recursion means repetitive use of a function. Then storage classes. Different storage classes are there, just like auto, static, global and register. Last unit is arrays. So we will see here introduction to arrays, how to declare array in a program, what is bound checking, what are different types of arrays, single dimensional arrays, two dimensional arrays, then we have to implement functions in an array. This is the list of different reference books. You can use these books. Thank you.